Hi, welcome to the third video in my procedural animations series. I finally decided to give the spider a proper body. Staying true to my goal to not use resource packs, I designed three torso variants using only block display entities and vanilla assets. There's a flat variant, a boxy variant, and a militaristic or stealth variant. Of course, you can further customize the designs by changing the block palette, size, and body plan. One unusual way to customize the model is to change the brightness of the display entities. The default value was 15, but you can lower it all the way to 0 for pitch black. In fact, I used this for the stealth variant because at first, when I used black concrete, all the shape details blended together due to how dark the texture was. To fix this, I used grey concrete instead and then lowered its brightness. Using the same idea, I darkened the other textures in the leg models. I also completely overhauled the cloak system. I wrote a script to crawl the Minecraft assets folder and generate a list of blocks with their average color. Using this list, the cloak can look up the color for any block, and likewise display any color by finding the closest match in the list. This allows me to interpolate the color value to create a smooth transition effect, similar to what I did in my 3D renderer video. Using the brightness option, I was able to further increase the number of available colors by generating 15 darker shades for each block. Previously, I managed to make the leg segments bend in the same direction by reinitializing the chain every time I applied the fabric algorithm. However, in the new leg designs, one of the segments bends differently from the rest. To support this, I added an initial rotation parameter for each segment, so I could have some control over how the chain resolves. Of course, this is still just a shortcut with many limitations, so we may want to implement a proper constraint system in the future. Now that the spider has a visible body, it looks odd that it can only rotate on one axis. To support 3 degrees of rotation, I rewrote the plugin using quaternions, as they tend to be easier to work with than Euler angles. To calculate the target orientation, I take the vector between the front and back legs and use it to calculate the pitch. Likewise, I take the vector between the left and right pairs and use that for the roll. I give the spider about 30 degrees of leeway so it can look at the player or at the laser. I considered rotating the scan bars as well so it could scale steep terrain. But this feature still needs quite a bit more work. I've disabled it in the meantime, but you can re-enable it in the settings if you want to try it out. Next, I wanted the spider's body to rotate when struck by a trident, so I implemented angular velocity. In the process of adding this feature, I accidentally created a subtle spring effect when the spider rotates. I decided to keep it, and you can exaggerate or dampen the effect by tuning the parameters. Since version 1.21.3, it has been possible for servers to receive user input directly. Using this feature, I was finally able to support keyboard controls. This was something I wanted to do in the past using horses, but there were too many problems in making it work reliably,